Hello everyone, this is Priya Hojai and you're watching NDH Prime Time. First the headlines. Dalmia company violates PWD rules. DC briefs media about Assam Assembly election. Half long observed Assam Sports Festival. Kanhaiya Kumar to camping in Assam. Lanka to hold Dimasa Sahitya Sabha. Now the news in details. As per the norms of PWD, heavy loaded vehicles are not allowed to ply over the PWD road, but in Umrangso, many heavy loaded vehicles of Dalmia Cement Company based at Umrangso were seen plying over the PWD road violating the rules. As a result, main road as well as many local roads were in deplorable condition. Mentionable that PWD has fixed a board which clearly reads heavy loaded vehicle not allowed, and that concerned department also issued notice on 19th of December 2015 directing that vehicles with a maximum load of 15 metric ton will be allowed to ply on the road. As a matter of fact, Dalmia should look on for development towards the area. Instead, the company is polluting the environment at Umrangso and the local people are the worst sufferer. Moreover, the roads which the company repaired are just for formalities. It has also been reported that if anybody points any accusing finger towards company, the company is always ready with well-prepared answer that is bribe. Dalmia company is tied up with many satellite TV channels and those channels dares to flash negative news against the company, the report say. Deputy Commissioner Amarendra Barua held a meeting regarding the upcoming assembly elections at his office on 8 March. Along with him, Superintendent of Police Dr. Dhananjay Parashuram Ganawat also briefed about the security aspect during the election. Briefing about the election plan to media, DC also gave a gist about the demography of Dimahasao. This district was created on 2nd February 1970 with a total area of 4,890 square kilometer. On its east is Nagaland and Manipur, west is Meghalaya and Karbi Anglong, on the north is Nagaon and Karbi Anglong, and south is Kachar. The total population of Dimahasao is 2,14,102, of which male population is 1,10,802 and female is 1,03,300. The total number of electors is 1,25,375. The district has now three subdivisions, Haflong, Maibang and Diumra. Deputy Commissioner Barua informed that there are a total of 203 polling stations, of which each have been identified as 53 numbers hypersensitive, 61 numbers as sensitive, 89 as normal, 69 as urban and 134 as rural. There are a total of 14 zones, 53 sectors, 20 arrows, 20 blow supervisors, booth level agents with 203 numbers representing of Indian National Congress, 179 numbers representing BJP, 14 zonal magistrates, 53 sector magistrates and 32 numbers of shadow area. Number of presiding station is 244 and number of polling officers are 732. The voters can cast their votes by the EVM machines as per the guidelines issued by the Election Commission of India. SP Ganawat informed that the entire district police is inadequate preparedness for the pre-election, during election, post-election and till the entire process is completed. With the other part of the state, Haflong has observed 9 March as Assam Sports Festival Day at Government Boys High School Playground. In the program, students of different schools competed in different games like tug of war, kabaddi, cockfight, musical chair, etc. Apart from that, to motivate small students, a friendly football match was also played between team of Dimahasao journalist versus teachers team, where teachers team defeated Dimahasao journalist 1-0. In the program, Tradeep Barua, Assistant Jailer, Sub-Jail, Haflong attended as the chief guest. JNU student leader Kanhaiya Kumar is likely to camping for the left parties in next month's Assam Assembly election. CPM leader Deven Bhattacharya said that six left parties have decided to contest the elections under the banner of United Left Forum. Veteran CPI leader Dhruvat Borgohain said that there was a possibility of Kumar camping in Assam. The JNU-SU president, who is facing sedition charges, is likely to camping for the left parties in West Bengal and Kerala also. Tripura CM and CPM leader Manik Sarkar has already confirmed of camping in Assam. Bhattacharya said that they will request other top leaders including Politburo members to camping in Assam, but simultaneous election in West Bengal and Kerala could make availability of top leaders difficult. The 8th General Conference of Dima Lairidi Mel Dimasa Sahitya Sabha is all set to start on 12th and 13th March 2016 at Hasabra, Barman Pather, Sambhariya, Lanka, Nogaon. That's all we have in our NDH Prime Time. For more updates, you can follow us on our Facebook page and YouTube channel. Keep watching NDH. Juthai.